Hi everyone, I am Anita, Assistant Professor, Department of BCA and IT. The subject today we are going to discuss is System Software and Operating System. So here we are going to see the subject description, its goal and its objective. So subject description, it deals with the fundamentals of system software and the resources of operating system. Next, the main goal is to get a knowledge on various system software and operating system concepts. And the main objective is to get sufficient knowledge on system resources. So as usual, the syllabus, it covers 5 units. So unit 1 and 2, it deals with the system software. 3, 4 and 5, it deals with the operating system concepts. So unit 1, here we are going to learn what is system software and its machine architecture. So here mainly we focus on loaders and linkers. So basic loader functions, what are all the basic loader functions, and we are going to see what is machine dependent loader features and what is machine independent loader features and how the loader is designed. So that is loader design options. So these are all the various things we are going to see in unit 1. And unit 2, it mainly focus on compilers. So here also we are going to see machine dependent compiler features, machine independent compiler features and compiler design options, P-code compilers, what is P-code compilers, what is interpreters and what is compiler compilers. So these are mainly focus on compilers in unit 2. And the next thing we are going to see is unit 3 is it mainly focus on operating system. So in operating system, we are going to learn what is process concept, definition of process, process states and what are the process state transitions and what do you mean by interrupt processing, interrupt classes, and then we will be learning what is storage management, how it is stored. So in that storage management, we will be seeing what is real storage, what are the real storage strategies we are following and contiguous, what is contiguous versus non-contiguous storage allocation. Then single user storage allocation, and finally we will be seeing what is fixed partition multiprogramming and variable partition multiprogramming. And the unit 4 mainly it deals with virtual storage, what are all the virtual storage management strategies we are following and page replacement strategies, demand paging, page size, working sets and finally processor management, that is job and processor scheduling, preemptive and non-preemptive scheduling and what are the priorities and deadline scheduling. And finally, in unit 5, mainly device and the information management system. So here operation of disk storage, why we need for disk scheduling, what is seek optimization and various file organization functions, how to allocate a file, freeing a file, file descriptor. So these are the 5 units we are having in our syllabus. So now we are going to see in depth about the unit 1. So before entering into unit 1, we need to know what is system software. So what is system software? What do you mean by software? A software is required. Why do we need a software? We need a software to run the hardware parts of the computer and other application software. And this system software, it acts as an interface between hardware and the user applications. Then system software, it converts all human instructions into machine understandable format. So types of system software are operating system, language processor and device drivers. So next we will see what is operating system. So operating system itself is a system software. And this is responsible for functioning all hardware parts and its interoperability. So operating system is the first software that is to be loaded in the computer memory. And it manages all basic functions like storing data in memory, retrieving files from the storage devices. Next, we are entering into our unit 1. So introduction. So we'll see the introduction of system software. So system software is a set of system programs. It is a collection of system programs. A system software consists of variety of programs that are supporting operations of a computer. This software makes it possible for the user to focus on an application or the problem to be solved without needing to know the details of how the machine works internally. So for system software, first the basic things we need to know is what is text editor and what is loader and linker, what is debugger and what is assembler. So text editor, it is nothing but a place for creating and modifying the programs. So text editor used by C, C++, Pascal language is used to create and modify the program. It is a place where we write the program or we modify the program. The next one is loader or linker. So loader or linker, it means the loader, it loads the program into the memory. So compilers, so here comes the concept compilers. So what is the function of a compiler? The compiler translates source program to a object program. The loader or a linker load the result object program into the memory and prepare for the execution. Next, what is debugger? Debugger, it helps in correcting and detecting the errors which are appear during the execution of a program. Next, assembler. Assembler, it includes a macro processor to translate assembly programs to a machine program. Next thing we are going to see is system software and machine architecture. So here we are going to see the machine architecture. So SIC, machine architecture, we are going to see here. SIC means simplified instruction computer. SIC, simplified instruction computer. So SIC comes in two versions. One is standard model, the other one is SIC XE. XE means extra equipment or extra expensive. So one is standard model, the other one is SIC XE. So SIC model, we are going to see a basic assembly language program. That is SIC assembly language program. Here we have basic assembler functions. So basic assembler functions like start, end, write, word, RESP, RESW. Start means start. It helps to specify name and starting address of the program. End means it indicates the end of the source program and specifies the first executable instructions. Byte, it generates the character or hexadecimal constant occupying as many bytes as possible to represent a constant value. Word, it generates one word integer constant. RESB means reserved bytes, to reserve the number of bytes for a data area. RESW, it means reserved word, to reserve the number of words for the data area. Next, simple assembler program. This is an example of a simple assembler program. So first thing is LDA. LDA space 5. LDA means load into register A. So it is nothing but load constant 5 into register A. That is the meaning of LDA 5. Next, STA alpha. STA means store in alpha. Next one is LDCHCHARZ. LDCH means load character, that is character Z. So load character Z into register A. And finally STCH, C1. STCH means store character C1. So store in character variable C1. So this is a sample assembler program. And this assembler program, it will convert and it is loaded into memory for execution. So next we will be seeing what is object code program format. So assembler program, we will have an assembler program. Now this will be converted into object code program format. So here we have three records. One is header record, text record and the end record. So header record means it contains the program name, starting address of the object program. So for example, in header record, column 1, it specifies H. If the alphabet is H, it indicates it is a header record. And column 2 to 7, it indicates here we are going to specify the program name that we need to load in the memory. So column 2 to 7 specifies the program name. Column 8 to 13, here we are going to specify the starting address of the object program. And finally, columns 14 to 19, the length of the object program in bytes. So this is a format for the header record. So next we are going to see the text record. So text record, column 1, we are specifying the alphabet T. If it is specified as T, it is a text record. And column 2 to 7, the starting address of the object code in this record. And column 8 to 9, it is here we are going to specify the length of the object code in this record. And column 10 to 69, object code represented in hexadecimal format. And last is the end record. End record, the alphabet specified is E, and that is given in the column 1. And column 2 to 7, here we are going to specify the address of the first executable instruction in the object program. So next, the any assembler program, it has to go to one pass or two pass. So one pass means all the process happens in a single pass itself. Where in case of two pass, it has to go through pass 1 and pass 2. So in pass 1, certain operations are carried out, and in pass 2, certain operations are performed. So in pass 1, what are all the things is happening? Let us see. So first thing is, it will assign addresses to all statements in the program. So the assignment of address, for each and every statement, the address is assigned. Then it saves the values assigned to the labels for using the pass 2. So what are all the variables that we are going to use it in pass 2? Everything will get saved in pass 1. And finally, third one is, it performs the processing of assembler directives. So here only it processes the assembler directives. So these are only three steps carried out in pass 1. Next, pass 2. The first point is assembler instructions. Here the assembler instructions are carried out, that is, it translates operation code and lookup addresses. And the second one is, it generates data values defined by byte, word, etc. And the third one is, it performs processing of assembler directives, which is not done during pass 1. So what are all the assembler directives? It's not done in pass 1, will be carried out in pass 2. And then finally, it writes the object program and the assembler directives. So next we are going to see what is loader. So what is loader? So here we are going to see what is loading, what is relocation, and what is linking. So loading, it refers to bringing the object program into memory for execution. So loader is also a system program that performs the loading functions. And this loader, it supports relocation and linking. Next one is relocation. Relocation is nothing but the modifying the object program so that it can be loaded at an address different from the location originally specified. And finally, linking. Linking is nothing but combines two or more separate programs and supplies the needed information by creating references between them. Next, we are going to see is basic loader functions. So in this basic loader functions, we are going to see what is an absolute loader. So how the absolute loader is designed and how it is loaded in the memory. So here all the functions of the loaders are accomplished at a single pass. First, the header record is checked to verify the correct program has been presented for loading. Second, the portion of the area that is to be copied or selected is loaded to the memory location. So as each text record is read, the copy of the object code is moved to the indicated address in the memory. When the end record reaches the loader, it jumps to the specified address in the memory and begins execution of the loaded program. So this is a function of the absolute loader. So next we'll see the algorithm for an absolute loader. So algorithm for an absolute loader. So first begin. So begin. Then it reads the header record. So as I told you, first comes the header record, next is the text record, and then finally is the end record. So first it reads the header record. As I told you, it verifies the program name and the length, whether correct program is loaded in the memory for execution. Then it reads the text record. Then while record type not equal to E, do, it means the record type till it reaches the end of the record, this process has to be taken place. Next, if object code is in the character format, it will be converted into internal representation. Then that object code will be moved to the specified location in the memory. Then it read the next object program for program record. Then end, it jump to the address specified in the end record. And finally, it is ready for execution. Next, machine dependent loader features. Next topic is machine dependent loader features. Certain loaders are machine dependent. It is dependent on the machine architecture and design. So several independent programs are executed at the same time where sharing of memory is required. It is necessary for a programmer to specify the address of the program that is loaded to the memory. Any loader that depends on the machine address undergoes three different functions. One is loading, one is relocating, the other one is linking. The loaders are that allow the program relocation are called as relocating or relative loaders. So we'll see what is relocating loaders. So modification of a record is used to describe each part of the object code that must change the relocated program. The same program is reproduced whenas the location of the program and the object code of the program alters. Each modification of records specify the starting address and length of the fields whose values are to be altered. Next we will see what is program linking. So linking provides the external reference between the programs and examines the relationship between relocating and linking. The control section from different program unit could be assembled together independently of one another. They appear as separate segments of object code after assembly. Next we will be seeing the algorithm and data structure for linking loader. So the main data structure used here is ESTAB. ESTAB means external symbol table. So the main data structure needed for our linking loader is a external symbol table, ESTAB. It is used to store the name and address of each external symbol in the set of control sections being loaded. So the other important variables used here are PROGADDR. It is nothing but program address. Then CSADDR, it means control section address. CSLTH means control section length. So the program address, it is the beginning address in memory where the linked program to be loaded. Its value is supplied by loader by an operating system. Next, CSADDR, it is nothing but control section address. It contains starting address assigned to the control section currently being scanned by the loader. And finally, CSLTH, it is nothing but control section length. It is used to find the length of control section program. And the next topic is machine independent loader features. So these loader features are not directly related to the machine architecture and design. That is, it is independent of the machine architecture. So in machine independent loader features, we are going to see two topics, that is automatic library search and loader options. So automatic library search, it is a standard system that specifies the control parameter and section to the particular loaders. Therefore, it is a subroutine called by the program, is loaded automatically and fetched from the library and then linked with the main program. This feature is defined as an automatic library call. Next is loader options. Loaders have a special type of command language that is used to specify the options. There are three special commands under the loader options. One is read, delete and change. So these are the commands. For read command, how we give the read command is include program name and the parameter will be library name. So that particular library name will be included in the program. Next, the delete command. The delete command deletes the entire control section specified. So for example, delete CSect name. CSect name is nothing but the control section name. And the next one is the change command. The change statement changes the section name 1 to section name 2 wherever it appears in the program. So this is how we have to give change name 1, comma name 2. So it changes from name 1 to name 2. So next thing is loader design options. So what are all the options for designing a loader? So it is done in two ways, linkage editor and linking loader. So we will see what is linkage editor and linking loader. So linkage editor, a linkage editor performs linking, relocation and loading. However, the linked program is returned to a file or a library instead of loading directly to the memory. And the thing is that it reduces the overhead when the program executes. So linkage editor, the linked program is returned to a file. So this is a diagrammatic representation of a linkage editor. So here we have a library. Library means all predefined things. Then we have an object program. So both the things will take as an input for the linkage editor. Finally, the program is linked and the relocating is performed. So this is a diagrammatic representation. Finally, it is copied or it is saved to a file. Where in case of linking loader, a linking loader, it performs linking and relocating operation and loads the linked program directly into the memory for execution. In linkage editor, it loads the linked program into a file, where in case of linking loader, it loads the linked program directly into the memory. And finally, the object program gets loaded into the memory. And the next topic is dynamic linking. Dynamic linking means linking that takes place at runtime or the execution time, that you call it as dynamic linking. And it is a scheme that postpones a linking function until execution time. And it is a subroutine that is loaded and linked to the rest of the program when it is called. This function is usually called as linking, dynamic loading or load on call. This dynamic linking, it allows several execution programs to share one copy of a subroutine or the library. So finally, the last topic we are going to see is bootstrap loader. So what is bootstrap loader? So when a computer is turned on or restarted, a special type of loader called bootstrap loader is executed. This bootstrap loader loads the first program that is to be run by the computer. This bootstrap loader always begins at address 0 in the memory and it loads the operating system, and this loader is used in a Unix situation. Here, all the object program from the devices has been loaded the bootstrap jumps to the address and begins the execution of the program that was loaded. So here we complete the unit 1. We'll have an overall thing. What are all the things we have seen in this? We have seen so far. We'll discuss in short. So here we have seen, we have given the introduction to system software. So what is machine architecture? So we have seen what is loader, what is linker, and we have seen what is machine dependent loader features and what is machine independent loader features, and finally we have seen what is loader design options. Thank you.